Welcome to class 8 students. I am going to continue with the chapter food production and its management. The topic that I want to start today is green revolution. Okay, now what is this green revolution about? The green revolution refers to a series of research and development and technology programs that took place between the 1940s and 1960s. Okay, the aim of this program was to increase the global food production. So this was the main aim of Green Revolution, to increase the global food production. Okay, especially in developing nations such as India. We all know India is still a developing country, a developing nation, and since it is a developing nation, there is scarcity of food and resources, and to overcome those challenges, this revolution was started to increase the global food production. India was basically at that time a starving nation. All the citizens of this country did not get enough food every day. Okay. Led by the American biologist Dr. Norman Borlaug, B-O-R-L-A-U-G, Dr. Norman Borlaug was a scientist who first started the Green Revolution. He was an American biologist. It involved the development of high yielding varieties of cereals, expanding farming areas, irrigation facilities, and using modern machines and chemical fertilizers to boost agricultural produce. So he gave some ideas in order to increase the global food production. What were those ideas? To involve the development of high yielding varieties of cereals. So he decided to introduce the development of high yielding varieties of cereals. So if a certain amount of cereal is high yielding, that means whatever the harvest will be, it will give a large amount of harvest than what is being sown. Okay. Next, also expanding farming areas. Irrigation facilities means to provide water supply to the agricultural field using modern machines. So initially in the agricultural practices, generally all the works, all the things or the processes of agriculture were done manually. People used to do it themselves. Now with the advancement of science and technology, many machines were produced which could do that work in much lesser time. Okay, so the manual energy was saved. Okay, using modern machines and chemical fertilizers to boost agricultural produce. Now previously I told you that chemical fertilizers are not good, organic farming is better these days and all those things, but this is also true that without chemical fertilizers producing harvest at a large scale, commercial scale, is impossible, because organic farming requires the use of biofertilizers and all those things which are extremely costly. It takes a lot of time using those biofertilizers. Also, harvest cannot be stored for a long time. So that is not, all those things are very much unwanted in commercial scale. So in commercial scale, to produce harvest, obviously chemical fertilizers are necessary. Okay. Now in India, this was done all over the world. Now in India, Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. M.S. Swaminathan. Okay. So Dr. M.S. Swaminathan started the Green Revolution in India. Dr. Norman Borlaug started it all over the world. But he could not take control of everything that is happening in all the countries, right? So all the countries who took part in this Green Revolution had a leader of their own. So in India, that leader was Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. So don't get confused between the two. If you are asked the question who first started the Green Revolution, your answer will be Dr. Norman Borlaug. But if in the question it is mentioned in India, when who first started it in India, clear, then your answer will be Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Am I clear? Next. The main points of green revolution are as follows. Number one, use of high yielding variety of seeds that mature in a short span of time. So if the seeds have short time span, then within a year a large number of seeds could be produced, a large number of harvest could be produced. Okay. Second point is use of manure, fertilizers and chemicals in the cultivation of crops. Okay. Third is multiple cropping by raising two or more crops on the same land. Multiple cropping means sowing varieties of seeds in the same land and they are growing all together. And obviously the requirement, the environmental requirement, the water requirement, all requirements of all of these crops should be similar, then only they can grow successfully in the same land. Okay. Use of machines such as tractors, harvesters, pump sets, all these things helped in this green revolution. Last point is improving infrastructural facilities for irrigation, harvesting, storage facilities, marketing facilities. Means the point was not only to increase the global food production. Obviously food is needed, but that also should be for commercial purpose as well. For commercial purpose as well, because if this increased food production could be sold in the market at a good rate, then the economy of the country will be better. So marketing facilities were also there, electrification and so on. All these actions brought about a revolution in the agriculture sector, leading to an abundance of food grains. So India became, see it is written here, the Green Revolution was led by the scientist Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Under his guidance, high-yielding, disease-resistant varieties of wheat and rice were produced. Why only wheat and rice? Because in India, our staple food is wheat and rice. Okay, India achieved great success in its Great Revolution and transformed from a starving nation to a food-exporting nation in 1978. So India, which was initially a starving nation, it became a food exporting nation. When can a country export something? When it has enough of something. It for its own people, if there is enough, and then only the extra will be imported to other places. Okay. So the food production was increased so much that India became a food exporting nation. Okay. So the Green Revolution is done. You have to read the points of Green Revolution here, and who first started Green Revolution in India, all these things you will have to read. Okay, in the next class I will start with animal husbandry.